Hi, it's Ron McTube. Today on Call of the Wild, the Angler, we're doing a lake trout guide because a lot of people want to know where they are. So I've been fishing for them solid for the last few days, trying to find all the hot spots, and I've got some really nice locations to share with you. So we're going to be using my setup. We'll have a look at that as well, what I'm fishing with, and I'm going to hopefully catch some for you now at this lake, which is very good. It's one of my favourite lakes for lake trout. Now, for lake trout, they're the biggest fish in the game. They really do need heavy gear. I've even been snapped on the heaviest setup you can get by one fish, like three times in a row. And I had my drag set really low as well, so they are a good challenge. But, like I say, location is the key thing with them. Now, I've been trying it early in the day, later at night, even in the night, and I'm still catching them. So time of day don't seem to make much difference. So let's check this location. Now, what you want to find is on certain lakes, you'll have certain hot spots or sort of spots where the fish congregate. So you look for things like lily pads, because fish will be around them. That's why they're there. Also, the boys always seem to have good fish around them as well, so they're key little locations to try out. Now on this rod, I'm going to be jigging. Now what you do with jigging and the lake trout, you basically want really deep water, or as deep water as you can find, normally over 20 meters. I think that's the lowest sort of depth, well, least lowest depth I've had them at, which is like 20 meters, but normally 30 plus meters you normally get them at. So what you want to do is, we're going to be jigging today, we drop our jig down, you just let it sink all the way to the bottom, and you'll know when it's the bottom because you can see on the right hand side it shows you the depth. So it's 37.8 meters. So once it's got to there and it's sunk down, we'll close the bail on, and all we're going to do is just keep flicking the rod tip up and down, and basically that's just jigging. You're just jigging it off the bottom and hoping one of these big lake trout spots it and then takes it. Now, your drag settings. This is the most powerful setup in the Angler, basically. Strongest rod, reel, line, reel, you know what I mean, everything. So, with this, I can play them harder, but the thing is, they will still snap this line. So you've got to be very careful. It's normally the first take as well, that's when I've been snapped. So what I do is I normally drop my drag down to, on the big fish, down to 10%, just for the initial bit. Let them take a bit of line and then slowly start turning your drag up. But yeah, I was on like 20%, and I caught a few lake trout already, but the real big ones was just snapping instantly on strike, taking it bang, and that's with the strongest braid you can get. So yeah, you got to be careful with it, but if you lower your drag initially, like right down, and then just up it after about 30 seconds of fighting them, you're good really with this setup. But match your setup to the fish you're fishing for. There's no good fishing for like small trout, for example, with this setup, or even medium fish, because you just reel them straight in and onto your boat. Do you know what I mean? It is meant for lake trout basically, and so balance is key if you want to have fun anyway. But yeah, I'm having a lot of fun with the Angler. What do you think? I know some people wanted a bit more sim experience, but overall I'm having a lot of fun, and it's only at release, so we're gonna get lots of fixes, tweaks, and the game will just get better and better over time. But yeah, I'm having a lot of fun. I spent about 5 or 6 hours yesterday just lake trout fishing. So I've been trying to get a diamond one. But now I found the key locations, it's only a matter of time. There's a lot of golden trout in here. So this lake, right, bottom left lake, is like diamond central. If you ain't got a diamond fish, you're looking for one, come down to here, this bottom left hand corner, because it's stuffed with them. I think some of that will get tweaked, changed. Maybe in a hot fix or a patch soon. But yeah, this lake does seem to have a lot of trophy fish in it. So as you can see, I'm just flicking the rod up, down, and you just keep doing that and you'll just get a take at some point. It might take quite a while, but you will get a take doing this. There's loads of golden trout around me. That one looks actually quite big. We might actually try and catch that. after we've got a lake trout. But yeah, it normally takes about 5 to 10 minutes when you're at the good locations. And it's just a case of keep jigging away. You can catch them in other methods, but I just think this is a really good method and it is very successful. Like I say, I've caught probably 30 big lake trout. So it definitely works well. So I thought I'd just show you because I know a lot of people, like in Discord, I was just making the video and then someone actually said, where's the lake trout? I need help, da da da. So I thought, and I just put like, I'm making the guide right now to help you out. So this will be out later today. As for other people, you've been asking about other content, so like Classic and Hunter Call of Wild. Don't worry, I'll be going back to that. It's just been a big few weeks, which is very unusual actually. Like two really big games releasing at literally the same time. So we had Way of the Hunter first, and then we had Call of Wild the Angler in the same sort of period. So I'll just be hopping in between content and just covering, making content that you want to see. So just drop in the comments what you want to see. Then the most popular thing I'll go and make. So we have got our first lake trout of the day. Now it's not too big. I know when it's big because I've got it at 30%. So basically, if it starts going red, or normally it's an instant snap on the really big ones. So ideally, I'd keep it lower than 30, like I was saying. 15, 10, 15 for the initial hookup. Just in case it is one of those giant lake trout. But like I say, this is really heavy gear and you still have to really take your time to bring it in. That lake trout is going in a minute. I'm gonna catch this and then we're gonna try and catch that lake trout because it looks quite a big one. But yeah, this lake is loaded with diamonds. So if you have to trophy fish, come to this bottom left corner. Like I say, I'll go over locations in a minute and my tackle setups. Like I say, time of day doesn't really matter. I see people saying, how do you change the time? Right, if you're in single player, it's just as simple as this. Close the game down and then relaunch it. And then the day basically restarts. Ideally, you could do with a functioning game to do it. I know not everyone wants to hunt, well, sorry, fish at night. But it would be nice to change it to the time you want to fish. Do you know what I mean? It would be a lot handier than having to leave the game and then coming back in. So here we go. Look at that monster. And that's a new best. Look at the size of that. You wouldn't need many of them for your dinner, would you? But yeah, they look really good. It looks like a massive like a brown trout. But yeah, really nice. Great trophy. And that's why everyone's wanting to get these. Does anyone in real life fish for these? Is watching the videos? Let me know about it. Do they look realistic? I want to know in the comments. But here we go, lots of XP and points. So we'll look at my setup, shall we? Leveled up. Right, let's have a look at my setup. Show you what I'm using. So as you can see, that's where we are down the bottom left. Like I say, look for the lily pads, boys. Let's have a look at my rods. So this is what we're using. That's the rod, very strong. You've got a bait caster reel, there you go. Strongest braided line. Braid's really good because it doesn't stretch much, so in real life it's you get a better presentation, I should say. So there you go, that's my setup. So try that, it's very good for lake trout. Now we're just gonna try and get this golden trout because it's been bugging me and it looks quite big actually. So we've got the old trusty spinnerbait on. This is like the money machine. The spinnerbait, if you want money, XP good, use the spinnerbait. Catches literally about everything and yeah, it's really good. So if you're starting out, it's a really good option and you get it by default as well. It's the first one you get. Come on, you've been sitting here all this time in the video trying to steal the limelight. Alright, here we go. I think that's the wrong one. We wanted the other one. It would be nice if they added like the fish rushing to lure. So like pike, for example. If you watch a pike, when it takes a lure sometimes, they will fly at insane speed and attack the lure. And I think we're missing a bit of that. I'd love to see that with some of the fish. They don't always just go up to it and just nibble it. Often they strike it quite hard. And I think I'd like to see that in the game. But it's just launched, so you're not going to have everything at launch. I see some people saying about Fishing Planet and other fishing games. You've got to remember, some of those have been out 7, 10 years time, right? So imagine how much development in like 5 or 7 years this would have. You'd have all the same sort of stuff. So you've got to give them a little bit of chance. It's just launched, and you're going to get lots of tweaks, fixes, new content coming along with development as it progresses. We all know the Hunter games, they evolve over many years and they get better and better. So can't wait to see what's in store for the Angler. I'm having lots of fun. Right, we've got this damn show off Golden Lake Trout. He's been hogging the video limelight. And that is a diamond. That's why I wanted to get on camera. He's like, get me on, Ron, get me on. Get me on a little spot. I'm a trophy. But there we go, diamond Golden Lake Trout. That's actually my first diamond Golden Trout, actually. So that's a nice addition, but that's not what we're after. But I've just shown you this location because, like I said, it's full of diamonds and trophy fish. Bottom left lake. But that's a nice little bonus. Let's get back to the lake trout, shall we? If you fish for any of these in real life, any species in game, let me know about it. Any tips for people on the game or about real life, just drop it in the comments, because a lot of people like to see it and they think, oh, that's how you do that. It helps everyone out. So, new location, we're dropping it down 37 meters here. But like I say, look for features. They tend to work really well. Lily pads, the buoys. We're just dropping it down, so drop it to the bottom, reeling a little bit, and then just start jigging up and down. I'd actually prefer it to have the up and down movement on my keyboard, or the option to do that, because my mouse is quite low sense, so it's actually quite hard to keep going up and down. But here we go, we're just gonna keep flicking it up and down. Gonna have to go back to the Hunter Color Wild soon. What would you like to see? Let me know in the comments. I need to go and check my red deer out, because I've been trying to get a super rare, either melanistic diamond or an albino diamond red deer. They're two of my most wanted trophies, and that's the reason why I started the red deer grind. I've got like 5 potential diamonds already on there, which I stacked up. And hopefully when we go back, now we've had a little break, I'll be refreshed and ready to roll. So, yeah, let me know in the comments what you want to see Color Wild wise. There's been an update in the Hunter Classic. Like I say, it's just been so busy. But we need to check that out. So there's lots of things to come and lots of content to make. It's just I can't make it all at the same time. I'm trying. And it's been non-stop for the last 4 or 5 weeks. I don't mind being busy. That's good. There's nothing wrong with being busy. That's better than not being busy, do you know what I mean? I'd rather have something to do, but Ron needs a break every now and again. I'm about ready for one. So come on. Come on, Mr. Lake Trout. As I said, it normally, sometimes on some good locations it's instant. But often it's about 5 or 10 minutes. You're jigging away, hoping for a lake trout. But that's normal. Like I say, that's not long in real time. Like I say, I've been some carp fishing lakes. I fished for 20 years and caught 2 fish from there. Really hard place though. But it was the feeling when I actually caught the fish, unreal. But I used to go literally every day to these same lakes for nearly 20 years to catch 2 fish. Basically, there's 3 old carp in there, very wily, and no one really caught them. Or one would get caught probably once a season. And I caught 2 of them out of the 3. But it took a long time. So I have got the patience. I do like lure fishing as well, because you're always moving, you're always doing something. what's your favourite fishing in real life? What's your favourite species you like to fish for, or you fish for near you? Is there any interesting species near you that most people can't fish for? I'd like to hear about that. Come on. Come on, fishy. Mr. Lake Trout. What do you want to see next in Call of Wild the Angler? Let me know in the comments. Your top three things you want to happen. DLC wise, fixes, updates, just let me know. Can be new maps, locations, styles of fishing, anything. Drop in your top three wants in the comments for the angler. What would I like to see most? Fly fishing. I don't know if that'd be my top one, but I would love to see it in game. Fly fishing on some of the mountain fin streams, you know what I mean, lakes and stuff. Yeah, that'd be amazing. I would like to see that. More species, obviously. Map wise, what would you like to see? Somewhere like Alaska would be interesting, wouldn't it? What else? You could have somewhere in Britain. What else could it be? Ice fishing. That'd be interesting. If they've done that right. So yeah, lots of ideas you could have. Fishing is so, it's almost limitless to what you could add. So it'd be interesting to see what does come next, content wise. There'll be loads of fixes and updates as well. That's about needing to be said, and I look forward to those. I'd like to see a roadmap as well, actually. I've said this a few times to the devs and the team. I'd love to see a roadmap early so we know what's coming. That would help, I think. So no Lake Trout yet, but as I said, sometimes it takes a few minutes. If you've got Call of Wild the Angler, let me know what you think of it. Are you having fun? Is there things you don't like? Honest opinions, put them in the comments. I don't mind. They're your opinions, so, you know what I mean? If that's what you think, that's what you think. There's nothing wrong with that. So, we've finally got one. And in it comes, hopefully. I don't think it's overly big, like the normal stamp. They're normally like gold. Small gold to high gold, and then you obviously got diamond. But I haven't caught one under gold yet, so I don't know if they do go like below that. But you'll know if we hook a really big one, because it'll go red, and if we're unlucky, we'll get snapped. But if we don't, I'll just drop the drag down to like 10, 15, and we're good again. It's just a case of patience and getting it in. I think the rod's a bit too soft. That's why it overly bends. They do hoop over in real life, the rods, but it seems like they bend a little too much. So I don't know how they go about that. You just want it so it doesn't bend as it does as much. But the fun aspect is there. That's the key. The core is decent, there's just some things that need tweaking. And I think we'll get those done anyway. You'll probably get a patch coming in soon, I think. I think they will release like a hot fix update soon. But I look forward to long-term support and what could happen for the game. So we've got our new Lake Trout, and what's this one? So he's 11 kilo. But look at the markings on that. They look absolutely stunning. Do you like the look of them? So as you can see, jigging works really well. Two at this location, and well, in real time, you've literally seen it. So it's not too bad. And we had a diamond golden trout. But there you go. Right, off to a new location. Let's have a look round. Some golden trout there. What else we got? I'm just seeing if he's out about. Let's move on. So that's what I normally do, get in the boat, glass around, see if I see any big fish on the top, and then we just move to various hot spots. spotted something nice in this. Where is it? Actually looks decent. Have a quick cast to that. I think this is a good thing with it. You've got lots of different species, varieties, so you can break it up. So I can go for lake trout, have a little spin with them, maybe use my bait rod, fish for something else. And often you find different species you're probably not after sometimes as well, which is good. But he's going to take it, get a bit more cash and XP. I'm going to buy a new rod set up soon. I might go for some ultra light stuff. Another golden trout. It all adds up, adds to the cash. And like I say, I could do another rod set up. I've just brought this big heavy set up, so that skinted me a little bit. But now we're getting these golden trout in. Get a few of them, get some money up. And when you level up, you get money as well. And then I'm going to start refining it, so getting rods, reels and lines really balanced for the species I'm after, so I can have really good fights. Come on, take the bait. We've got him. Ooh, you little rat. Slipped the hook. Is he going to come back? He is as well. You silly golden trout, you'd escaped. You haven't escaped now though. Another gold. Anything else? Right, let's move on, shall we? See if we can find anything. Hey, what's that? That looks big. That is a big golden trout. That might be a diamond. You can generally see, once you've seen a few big fish, you know like what the sort of stamp they are. And I think that might be a diamond. He's going for it, we'll soon find out. But one speed on a reel with a spinnerbait and you're set. Does make a big difference, the reel speed. Here we go. It is a diamond golden trout, so that's two diamond golden trouts. This bottom lake is full of trophy fish, so make sure you check it out. We're going to go over locations in a minute, actually. I'm going to show you where to go. So, it's been a great day fishing. Two really nice lake trout, two diamond golden trout, all at the same lake. And this is just one of the really good lakes to come to, the hot spots. So let's go over lake trout locations, the hot spots, where to find them, the best areas. So this bottom lake, as you can see, this is where we were. So the lily pads, as you go straight out the dock on your boat, go there where my cursor is, and then down to the back of it there's a buoy. It beeps. Fish on that. Lots of lake trout there. The next lake is the long thin lake just above it. Very, very good. I've had quite a lot of lake trout here. Same again, look for any features or the buoys. You always seem to get lake trout there because it's deep water. That's the main thing. Now this smaller lake, this is where I've actually had most of them. Same again, look for any features, but really good. I caught my biggest lake trout there at night. And this location at the top, this fourth lake, just past this island, I was catching him yesterday. So those four lakes are where you want to go. Time of day doesn't seem to matter. So they're the key locations, the key hot spots for lake trout, and I hope that helps you out. So I'm Rummick Tube. I've been making a lake trout guide for Call of Ward the Angler. Hope it helps you out. Please subscribe to my YouTube channels. I'm going to get back to fishing. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.